This call is now being recorded.
Okay, from yesterday due to network loss, I explained half of this. So once again, I will start this one. How to calculate the bearing of the angles. Okay, in compass surveying, in compass surveying we were getting the bearings directly, okay, bearings directly, but here in theodolite we don't have any but here we can measure the angle, but we won't get the bearings because we are not taking the measurement with respect to the knob. Okay, so how to determine the bearing of that station? For example, if I draw a closed traverse, if I draw a closed traverse like this, if I call this in station A, B, C, D, and E. Okay, so if I draw the quadrant like this, the station 1 A or line AB lies in the first quadrant. Okay, line BC lies in the second quadrant, CD lies in the third quadrant, okay, it lies in the fourth quadrant. It will lie in this fourth quadrant. Okay, this is how we were calculating the bearing, by calculating the foresight, forward bearing and back bearing. Okay, but here in case of theodolite, we can't directly calculate the bearings, so we have two methods to determine the bearings. Okay, one by included angle, another one by the deflection angle. Okay, so everyone please sit with pen and paper. Okay, I will explain the numericals now onwards. We have some numericals, not that much complicated, but you have to listen it very carefully. So included angle and the deflection angle. First we will go for the included angle. Okay, to know the whole circle bearing of any line, okay, any line, comma, add, what we should do, we should add whole circle bearing of a previous line, okay, from to the included angle. What we should add? We should add the whole circle bearing of the previous line plus the included angle. Okay, how, what will be the included angle? That is the angle made between the two lines. If I draw the closed traverse like this, okay, this is my included angle. Okay, what we should do, whole circle of the bearing previous line plus included angle between the those two lines. If this is A, B, C, D, okay, the whole circle bearing of this one and the included angle between these two lines. Again, whole circle of the previous one plus add these two, whole circle of the bearing previous one plus add. So by doing like that, we will get the bearing of that line. Okay, now while adding, what you are adding, whole circle bearing plus included angle if their sum is greater than 180 degree. If it is greater than 180 degree, then what we have to do? We have to subtract 180 degree. Okay, then only we will get the whole circle bearing of that line. If the summation of whole circle bearing plus included angle is lesser than 180 degree, is lesser than 180 degree, then what we have to do? We have to add 180 degree. The same thing what we have done in the compass survey. Okay, if the sum is greater than 180 degree, okay, what we have to do? We have to subtract. So we have to subtract 180 degree. Why? If the sum of is less than 180 degree, then we have to add 180 degree. Okay, after doing that, we will get the bearing in whole circle bearing. Correct. So this is the procedure to determine the whole circle bearing of that line by the method called as induced angle. Now, by deflection angle, this is also very simple. From whole circle bearing of the initial line always we will do. Okay, so whenever you do some survey work, okay, initially you will take the bearing of that point. Whenever you start or any type of work you start, first one is that we will determine the bearing of that point. Okay, so from the known whole circle bearing of the initial line means if I call this one as A, okay, we will be knowing the initial whole circle bearing. Okay, and then deflection angle of the whole circle bearing. Okay, then what we will do, either we will add or we will subtract. Okay, I will tell when we should add and when we should subtract. Okay, so here is the formula: whole circle bearing of any line which is equals to whole circle bearing of a previous line plus or minus deflection angle. Okay, if he mentioned in the tabular column, say like right or left. Okay, if it is okay right, then we will add it. Okay, if it is left, then what we will do? We will subtract. Okay, so after doing all that, that is whole circle bearing of the previous plus or minus the deflection angle. If the sum is greater than 360 degree, then we have to subtract 360 degree. If not, we have to add the 360 degree. Okay, then how to do check? Check is done by the whether to check whether we have done it correctly or not. That is bearing of the last line. Last line means here, that is A, B, C, D, E. Last line is what? E, A. Okay, last line. Bearing of the last line equals to forward bearing of the initial line. Initial line will be A, B. Okay, plus sum of the positive deflection angle, and this is not R, this is minus sum of negative deflection angle. Means the formula will be like this. You can write here bearing of last line, I will call as EA, which is equals to bearing of the initial line will be AB, okay, plus summation of positive deflection angle minus summation of negative deflection angle. Okay, this is how we do check. So we will go for a numerical. So the question is like this: the interior angle of a traverse ABCDE, okay, are measured as follows. So the angles they are given. Okay, with the help of the theodolite, we have measured the angles. Correct. So we have to determine the. Angle A is given. Means if I draw like this, this is A, B, C, D, E. Okay, here it has given 76 degree something. Here it is given 112 degree something. Here it is 98 degree. Okay, here it is 130 degree something, and here it is 123 degree. So, okay, so we have to the bearing of the initial line AB. Okay, this line, the bearing of initial line has given how much it is? 217 degree 15 minutes 20 seconds. How much? 217 degree 15 minutes 20 seconds. If I draw the quadrant like this, this is 0 degree, this is 90 degree, this is 180 degree, and this is 270 degree. Means the line somewhere lies here. Okay, that is A B line lies somewhere in the third quadrant. Okay, remember, just visualize whatever you have learned in the previous unit. Now he says that find out the bearing of the remaining sides. Remaining sides are BC, CD, DE, and EA. We have to determine the remaining angles. Okay. So here we will go for the first one. He has given the included angles. So in included angles, how you will determine? Here we have the formula, that is whole circle bearing of the previous line plus included angle. Okay, what is the formula? Whole circle bearing of the previous line. Previous line is what? BA plus included angle. Like this. Okay, and if its sum, okay, if its sum is greater than 180 degree, then what we will do? We will minus deduct the 180 degree. We will get the whole circle bearing of that one. Suppose if the sum is lesser than 180 degree, then we have to add 180 degree. Very simple. Okay. So here, the bearing of a line AB, how much it is? I will call this one as the whole circle bearing of the previous line. Okay. Then what we should add? We should add angle B. Okay. Add included angle. After adding, you can see it is greater than what? 180 degree. So if it is greater than 180 degree, then what we have to do? We have to subtract. We have to subtract 180 degree. So the above sum, it is greater than 180 degree. What we are doing? We are subtracting 180 degree. Therefore, we have got the bearing of that line, that is BC. Okay. ABC. Okay. We have got the bearing of AB. Now we have got the bearing of BC. Correct? Now we have finished with the first step. Then we will go for the second step. Second step, again, whole circle bearing of the previous, okay, plus included angle. Okay. Now see, what is the previous bearing angle? It is BC. How much it is? 150 degree, 2 minutes, 20 seconds. Okay. Plus, okay, what is the included angle he has given in the question? How much? That is 98 degree, 12 minutes, 40 seconds. Therefore, add. Okay, so we are ending with the result, that is 248 degree, 15 minutes, 0 seconds. Okay, and you can, here you can see it is greater than how much? 180 degree. If it is greater than 180 degree, what we have to do? We have to deduct it. So we have got the bearing of the line CD, means this one. We have got the bearing of this line CD. Okay, then we want the bearing of line, which line? This DE. How we will do? That is D, we need DE. Okay, that is whole circle bearing of previous line plus what is the previous, oh, what is included angle? It is 130 degree 920. That is 120 degree 9 minute 20 seconds. 130 degree 9 minute 20 seconds. If I add these two, okay, how much I am getting? 98°24'20". Okay. Now see, this is how much it is greater than 180°. Now, if it is greater than 180°, what we have to do? We have to subtract. That is 198°24'0" minus 180°0'. After doing subtraction, how much I am getting? I'm getting 18°24'0". Okay. So previous line, included angle, and we got this bearing which is greater than 180°. So what we have did? We subtracted. So we have got the bearing of the line DE. Now, if I draw the diagram like this, A, B, C, D, E. We have got the bearing of this one. Now we need for EA. Okay, how we will do for EA? EA we need, okay, which is equals to whole circle bearing of previous one plus included angle. What is the whole circle bearing of the previous one? It is 18°. That is 18°24'20". What is the included angle here? If I see the question, it is 123°14". So what I will do? 123°14'0". Okay. If I add, if this is not 180, this is 18. Okay. So it is how much? 141°38'30". Okay. So now see, you can see this is greater than how much? 180°. Sorry, lesser than 180°. So we have to add. In previous thing, what we have done? We have subtracted because it is greater than 180°. But this one, it is lesser than 180°. So what we are doing? We are adding this one. So we have got the bearing of line EA. Okay. Next. So EA is here. Okay, we have got the bearing of the line E. No. So I'll erase this one. Okay. So we have got the bearing of the line EA. Correct. Now, if you can check whether this given bearing is correct or not. Initially, how much he has given? That is 217°15'20". Okay. So what we will do? We will take the angle. For previous one, that is 221°38'30" plus angle A, how much it is? Angle A, it is 76°12". 76°12". We are getting this much. It is greater than 180°. So what we are doing? We are subtracting. So we have got the bearing of the line AB. Okay. So this is the check. Okay. So anybody having doubt here? Be fast. Comment either yes or no. Or you can unmute and tell. Okay. So we have seen about the included angle. Suppose if we give the deflection angle, okay. See here, we have solved about by using the included angle. Now we have to solve using the deflection angle method. In deflection angle method, what you do? That is, whole circle bearing of the previous one plus or minus deflection angle. Okay, when you will take plus, if you mention it is right one, and if it is mentioned it is the left one. Okay, and how you check, and how do you check it is calculation, sorry, last bearing which is equals to initial bearing, that is AB line, plus sum of positive deflection angle and minus sum of negative deflection angle. Okay, we will see in the example. Okay, here you can see the following deflections are measured in a running traverse from L to R. Okay, so we have M, N, O, P, Q. Actually, now deflection angle, how much he has given? That is 23 degree, 18 degree, 37 degree, 15 degree, 10 degree, etc. Okay, now you can see here he has mentioned right face, left one, right one, left one, right one. Okay, if it is right, what we will do? We will take positive, negative, positive, positive, negative. Okay, if I split like this, it is 23 degree, 47. Okay, right hand side, and here left hand side it is 18 degree 19 minutes. Again here 37 degree 20 minute, and again here left only two lefts are there, that is 10 degree 12 minutes. Okay, here how many rights are the 1, 2, 3? Okay, another one is 15 degree 38 minutes. Okay, these all are additive and these all are subtractive. Okay, and if I take the sum, okay, if I take the sum, this means sum of all left one, it is 31 minute 28 degree. Okay, this one it is 5, 4, 76. Okay, so just remember this one. No. And here he has given the true line bearing of LM is north 62 degree 18 minute east. Okay, calculate the true bearing of the remaining side. That is, our line is that L, M, N, O, P, Q, and R. Like this, it is there. We have to determine the bearing. But remember one thing. Okay. Remember one thing. We know to do calculation in the whole circle bearing. Okay. But here the bearing he has given, it is in which type? It is a reduced bearing. Now anyone tell me, be fast, just I'll give a glance. So my whole circle bearing of a line AB which is equals to 45 degree, okay, then what will be the reduced angle? Be fast. The angle in whole circle bearing is 45 degree. What will be the angle in reduced bearing? No. Whole circle bearing. See, the line is here. Okay, it is 45 degree. Then in reduced bearing, it will be north 45 degree east. North, south, east, west. So in whole circle bearing it is 45 degree, but in reduced bearing it is north 45 degree east. Now can anyone tell me the whole circle bearing of a line AB is 135 degree, what will be the reduced bearing? Anyone?
साउथ 45 डिग्री
करेक्ट ईस्ट. नाउ कैन एनीवन टेल इफ द होल सर्कल बेयरिंग इट इज 210. होल सर्कल बेयरिंग इज 210 डिग्री एंड व्हाट विल बी द रिड्यूस्ड बेयरिंग. It will be south 30 degree west. Okay. Suppose it is whole circle bearing. It is say 310. Then what will be the radius bearing?
North 50 degree west.
North
50 degree west.
50 or 40? 310 minus 70. North 40 degree west. Okay, like this. From whole circle to bearing, and from see, if it is lying in between the first quadrant, means you people should be touch with the subject regularly. Okay, south east west. Okay, if it is in the first quadrant, the whole circle will be equals to the northeast direction. Okay, if it is lying in the second quadrant, okay, it will be southeast. It is 180 to 270, it will be southwest. If it is 270 to 360, it is northwest. Okay, our whole circle bearing will go in a clockwise direction. Okay, this is the first quadrant, second quadrant, third quadrant, and fourth quadrant. Okay, see, if it is in the northeast direction, then the reading will be directly. If it is in the southeast direction, we have to subtract 180 degree. If it is southwest, means first quadrant, second quadrant, third quadrant, and fourth quadrant. Okay, so here we have to add, and here we have to subtract 360 degree. Okay. So tonight I will go for the numericals. Okay. after the class try to go through the previous unit, okay? Now to determine the produced bearing, whole circle bearing. Okay, so initial bearing he has given, that is 62 north, 62 degree 18 minutes east. North, south, east, west. Okay, he has given 62 degree north 62 degree 18 minutes east. Okay, so which will be equals to the whole circle bearing. Okay, we have to convert it into the whole circle bearing. That is, it will be the same 62 degree 18 minutes. Then what is our formula? That is whole circle bearing of the previous one plus or minus the deflection angle. When you use plus, it is mentioned right. When you use minus, it is mentioned left. Okay. So whole circle bearing of the previous line plus the angle. So we have got how much? 86 degree 5 minutes. It will be in terms of whole circle bearing. And if we ask in the reduced bearing means, you can just convert into the same thing. Okay, so it is lying in the first quadrant, therefore the whole circle bearing will be equal to the reduced bearing. Okay, then now remember this one, previous whole circle bearing, how much it is? 86 degree 5 minutes. Okay, then the next line, NO means whole circle bearing of the previous line plus or minus the deflection angle. What was the previous one? It is 86 degree 5 minutes. Okay, the next angle, it is how much? 18 degree 9 minutes left. Okay, so if left means what we have to do? We have to subtract, that is 18 degree 19 minutes. Okay, we have done. Got the bearing. Okay, which will be equals to whole circle bearing because it is lying in the first quadrant. Okay, then we have L, M, N, O, P, Q, R. Okay, so we have finished with L, M, M, N. Now O, P. We have with O, P. O, P. Previous bearing, how much it is? 67 degree 46 minutes. Okay. Plus angle, how much is given? This one. Okay, and it is right one. Okay, so we are adding. So we have got the whole circle bearing. So if I draw the circle like this, if it is like this, 105 degree 6 minutes. So we want in a quadrant system or reduced bearing system, means what we will do? We will deduct 180 degree. Okay, so 180 degree minus this one, so we will get this angle, that is south 74 degree 5 minutes east. Okay, then we will go for the next line, that is PQ. What is the bearing of the previous line? We have to take the whole circle bearing, that is 105 degree. 105 degree 6 minutes plus angle he has given, that is right angle. Okay, so after adding we are getting how much? 120 degree 44 minute. Okay, if you want to convert it into the reduced bearing, check where it is lying. It is lying in the second quadrant, therefore what you do? 180 degree minus this angle you will get in the reduced bearing. Okay, or quadrantal bearing. Next line, what is it? Is QR. QR, what you have to do? We have to take the whole circle bearing. Okay, whole circle bearing of the previous line plus or minus the included angle. Here it is left angle, so we are deducting it. We have got whole circle bearing as how much? 110 degree 32 minutes. Okay, if I draw the diagram like this, it is 110 degree. Again, what we will do? 180 degree minus this one. Okay, so we have got the everything. Now we want to do check. Okay, whether we have done correctly or not. So bearing of the last line. Okay, bearing of the last line. Last line is what? QR, which is equals to bearing of the first line. First line is what? LM. Okay. Then summation of the deflection angle minus summation of the left angle. Here it is right angle. Here it is left angle. Now here, how many left angles are there? 1, 2. Okay. Add these two. 1, 2. After adding, how much we are getting? That is 28 degree 31 minute. Now summation of right angles. Add all the right angles. 1, 2, 3. We have all these three. Add them. 1, 2. Actually, it is 15 degree 38 minute. Okay. Adding that, we have, how much we have got summation? That is 76 degree 45 minutes. Okay. Then how we will check the previous one? See here, how much we have got? 110 degree 32 minutes by regular calculation. Okay. Now we are doing check. Okay. Now pre whole circle bearing of the previous one. Okay. Summation of the right angles. Summation of minus summation of the left angles. How much we are getting? We are getting 110 degree 32 minutes. Okay. These two are same. Then whatever you have done, it is correct. So anybody having doubt here? Comment yes or no, or you can tell. If you are having doubt, means you can unmute and you can tell. Anybody having doubt? Take the screenshot of this one. Be fast. It is assignment. In next class, I will ask. Okay. So take this one as assignment one. Be fast. I hope you have taken the screenshot of this one. Remember that here he has given the included angles, and he has mentioned left, right, left, right, right. Okay, three rights are there and two lefts are there. Initially he has given 110 degrees 6 minutes. Okay. Then next type of problem. This is also same. Okay. What you do? Take this one as also assignment problem. Take this one as assignment. Take the screenshot. So we will go for the next type of numericals, and chances of getting this type of numericals is MCQs are more. Okay, because the numericals are very easy, okay, and very simple one. So for one mark question, they can ask these types of numericals. Okay, try our computation. If we consider, okay, see, remember this coordinate system. North, south, east, west. Okay. If we consider two directions at right angle, the north, south, and east, west, means these are the two directions which are perpendicular to each other. East, west. Each of the line of polygon PQRS has a projection on them shown in the figure. Okay. It is easy to see the algebraic sum of the projections in southeast and east, west direction. We have already learned in the first year. Okay, these things we have already learned in the first year. So here nothing more is there. we give importance to this latitudes and departure. Latitude means the lines will be, if I draw the coordinate system like this, the lines which are parallel to the or running from north to south, okay, these are called as latitudes, and the departures are east west lines. Okay, very simple, these are the north south and these are the east west. Okay, next, what are the latitudes? The projection of a survey line parallel to the north south meridian. Okay, this is north south, the lines are parallel to north south meridian. Okay, the latitude line is a parallel to north south direction. Latitude is positive or negative. When we have to consider it is positive and when we have considered it is negative. Okay, when the latitude is in the direction towards north, okay, in question you will mention whether it is towards north or towards south. If it is towards north, we will take it as a positive. Okay, towards north it is positive and it is called as northing. Okay, in numericals we will mention whether it is northing, southing, easting or westing line. Okay, it is nothing but if this is your plan, if the lines are towards your north or lines are towards the south, if the lines are towards the east or towards the west. Okay, so just remember, if I draw like this, it is positive and this is negative. Okay, similarly in latitudes, what we will do, we will take it as a positive, here we will take it as a negative, same as your coordinate system, that is plus plus plus. Minus plus, minus minus, and plus minus. Okay, in algebraic system you have learned this already. Okay, this is plus plus, this is minus plus, means x axis, y axis. Here both x axis and y axis are positive. Here x is negative and y is positive. Here both x and y are negative, and here x is positive and y is negative. Okay, in engineering mechanics, okay, you already learned about this one, force resolving of the force. Okay, resolving of the force, when you took positive and when you took negative, the same thing we are doing here. Instead of force, here we are doing with the dealing with the line. Okay, okay, when the latitude is in the direction towards the south, it is taken as the negative and we'll call it as a southing. Here we'll call it as a northing, here we'll call it as a southing. Okay, see, this is your force. Okay, engineering mechanics, I'm applying engineering mechanics here. So what we are doing, we were splitting the lines like this. Okay, in x axis, in y axis, if I draw like this, if this is your force, this x axis we will call it as, if this is a theta, this will be p cos theta. Okay, and this will be p sin theta. Okay, I hope you are familiar with the resolving of the force. Okay, if I split like this, this will be the p cos theta and this is p sin theta. If the angle is making here, suppose if the angle is here, okay, touching the y axis, if I split means it will be reverse. This will be p sin theta and this will be p cos theta. Okay, here what we are doing, here instead of taking p, we are taking l. L is nothing but the length. Okay, and always remember, here our y axis is making theta is making with respect to y-axis. So here the latitude it is given by L equals to capital L equals to small l into cos theta. This departure will be equals d equals to L sin theta. Okay, remember this one, very important. Same thing. Okay, instead of taking p force, here we are taking the length. Remember this formula. See, our always our angle makes with respect to north. Okay, if I draw like this, this is my force p and this is my theta. Okay, then the horizontal force will be p cos theta. Okay, and the vertical force will be p sin theta, correct? But here in our case, it is making here with respect to y axis. So here it is making with respect to x axis. So here it is making with respect to y axis. So here it will be little bit reverse. H equals to, that is horizontal is nothing but in, I will write here only. If I draw like this, H is nothing but the departure line. Okay, V is nothing but the latitude. Okay, here H is p cos theta, but here our angle it is making with respect to y axis, therefore it is L sin theta. Okay, and here L it, p sin theta is there, so here it will be L cos theta. Okay, very simple. So this is our formula for L cos theta, where L is the length of a line and T is the reduced bearing of a line. Okay, very simple. Next, what is departure? Departure, I have said, the projection of a survey line perpendicular to the north-south direction. Okay, this is north, south, east, west. Okay, perpendicular to this is the north-south, and what will be the perpendicular? This will, this line will be the perpendicular. Otherwise, in case you can say parallel to the east-west. Okay. But in surveying, what we will do, we will go with respect, we will measure the angle with respect to north or south. Okay, so what we are saying, it is a line perpendicular to the northeast. Okay, remaining thing I have explained already. Okay, the departure it will be, the formula is line L sin theta. Next, errors in closing. Okay, here he has mentioned the lines like this. Okay, A, B, C, D, E. Okay, here you can clearly see, here it is P dash, here it is P. It should touch to the P. Okay, our last line should coincide with the this. But the dotted line, what you see, it is a closing error. Okay, the same thing what you have done in the compass surveying. Okay, here what little bit change is there. Here you have to verify how much, what is the total angle. If it is a rectangle, it will be 360 degree. So you have got how much? 365 degree. How much degree it is difference? Of 5 degree it is difference. Okay, how many sides are there? 4 sides are there. Therefore, 5 degree divided by number of sides. So there will be distribution. Now, after this one, we have to check the altitudes. In engineering mechanics, what you have learned, that equilibrium equation, summation of vertical force is equals to zero, summation of horizontal force is equals to zero. Correct? Here also same. The summation of what L latitudes are zero. Summation of the departure lines are zero. Okay, upward force you have taken positive, downward force you have taken negative. Correct? Here also same. Northing force we will take it as positive, southing we will take it as a negative. Okay, easting we will take it as a positive, westing we will take it as a negative. Same engineering mechanics is applied here. Okay, closing error it is taken as, that is resultant equals to square root of summation of V square plus summation of H square, vertical force plus summation of horizontal force. Here also the vertical force and the horizontal force. Okay, how we have find the theta? okay, that is tan inverse of summation of V upon summation of H, correct? Here also the same, summation of D upon summation of L, we will get the angle. Same thing we are doing here, okay? So anybody having doubt here up to this concept? I will go for directly to the numericals. If anybody having doubt means, I will explain and then I will go to the numericals. Anybody having doubt?
No, sir.
Okay. This one, just remember, I will explain at last. Otherwise, I'll explain it now only. So here he has given. First, I will read the. This is the simple one. Okay, don't get complicated. Only the thing is that you will get confused about the coordinates. Okay, don't get confused about this one. This is just x-axis and y-axis. Okay, x-axis, y-axis. Okay, I will explain this one. If you understand the first numerical, means the rest is very same. Okay. So here he says that find the length, okay, and the bearing of a line of PQ. Okay, here there is a line called PQ. You have to determine the length. What is the length? Okay, then you have to determine the bearing. Okay, with respect to, okay, this is P, this is Q. We have to determine the bearing. How you determine? Okay. Very simple. Here he has given point A and point B. Here he has given the coordinates. Okay, this is our x-axis, this is our y-axis, this is our x-axis and this is our y-axis. The first step is that we have to determine the length. Okay, what is the length? Or in case you can say, what is the load? Force. Okay, we have to determine the force. And here, we have to determine the reduced bearing angle, that is theta, we have to determine. Now, here we have to determine the latitude of the line PQ. Okay. Here x-axis, y-axis is nothing but the north axis, south axis, north, south. Okay, so what we will do, it is very simple. What you do, just this minus this and this minus this. Okay, so latitude of a line PQ, it is 1200.40 minus 970.50. okay, you have got this 229.90. okay, then departure line, it is 206.20 minus 850.40. okay, you are getting this one. For example, say P equals to 4 cm, 6 cm, Q equals to 3 cm, 2 cm. Okay, you have to draw in a graph. Okay, this is our graph. How you will draw? Very simple. First, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, like this. Okay, here it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, like this. Say that 4 it is here, 6 it is here. Okay, and 3, somewhere it is here, 2 it is. I will take this one as 8, 10. Okay. First point I will calculate, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, okay, here I got this one, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, here I got this one, so I have got P point. Now I want this Q point, it is, x-axis how much it is, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, somewhere so I call like this, and y-axis it is 10, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, somewhere I have got like this, now I have got Q. So with the help of the coordinates, I have got the x-axis line P and Q. Now what I have to do? I have to determine the length and this angle theta. Very simple. Okay. So here we have got this latitude and departure. Okay, theta, how we will find out theta? That is departure upon latitude. That is tan inverse theta equals to tan inverse of d upon l. How much we have got theta? Theta equals to 47 degree 11 minutes 31 second. So we have got the bearing. Then what he is asking? He is asking the length. Okay, since the latitude is positive and the departure is negative, okay, the line PQ lies in the fourth quadrant. If I draw like this, this is plus plus, okay, this is minus plus, this is minus minus, this is plus minus. Okay, see, here we have plus and here we have minus, so it lies in the fourth quadrant. Okay, in talking in terms with respect to the surveying means it lies in the second quadrant. Okay, in terms of algebraic, this is the first quadrant, second quadrant, third quadrant, fourth quadrant. In terms of mathematics, in terms of civil surveying, this first quadrant, second quadrant, third quadrant, fourth quadrant. Okay, so now it lying in which quadrant? Fourth quadrant, because x axis is positive and y axis is negative. Okay, x axis is positive and y axis is negative, correct? Sorry, this is made a confusion. I should not bring the mathematics here. Here it is 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. The latitude is positive here and the departure is negative here. If you see, while explaining that one, sorry, made a little bit confusion bringing mathematics here. So northing is always positive, correct? Southing is always negative. Here the easting is positive and here westing is negative. Okay, now latitude is positive here and departure is negative, therefore we will go for the fourth quadrant, that is northwest. Okay, that is northwest. Now we have got this one angle, then we have to convert it into the whole circle bearing. Okay, if we ask to give in a whole circle bearing, means keep it in a whole circle bearing, otherwise we can end up with here. Okay, then we have to determine the length. How will determine the resultant force? That is summation of v square plus summation of h square. Okay, what is the summation of l? Here we can see this is our l and this is our h. This is our L and this is our H. We have to do summation of V square, summation of H square. Okay. So doing that one, we have got how much? 338.31 meter. Correct? This is how we will do. Determine the length. Okay, if you want to determine, if you want to do check, means we know that summation of L equals to L cos theta, sorry, L summation of L equals to zero, correct? Now what is the length here? We have to find out the L. That is, we are checking it cos theta. Theta we always will write in the reduced bearing. So this is summation of L, summation of latitude. How much are there? Only one latitude is there, we have taken that one. So after solving, how much we have got the value of L? L we have got 338.31. okay, if I open the scientific calculator here, Okay, so here the latitude is there, departure is there, negative. So in latitude, you can see here it is mentioned minus. It is nothing but the southing. Here it is northing, northing. We have to determine whether it is northing or southing. In departure, if it is negative, means it is west. It is east, west. Sorry, again it is east. Okay. So you have to, if you want, you can split it like this. Otherwise, you can keep it the same. Okay. Here it is line AB. The first one is negative, you can see. So I have written in the south. Okay. And the departure, it is also negative. So I have written in the west. Next, BC. It is northing, easting. Okay. Because both them are positive. CD. It is positive, positive. Okay. Summation of this northing, summation of southing, summation of easting, summation of westing. Okay. Now here we have to determine the missing thing. Okay. Missing latitude of DA and departure for DA. Okay. So first one, let L equals be the length of the line DA. Okay, we have to determine the length and the bearing, and theta be the bearing of the line DA. Okay, we know that summation of L equals to 0, summation of D equals to 0, correct? So, and here what I will do, here in missing one, what I will write? I will write L cos theta. Okay, here I will write L sin theta. Okay, now add all these things, minus, plus, plus, and this one. Okay, minus, plus, plus, and this one. So, and adding all those things, how much you will get? It will be equals to zero. Okay, summation of this latitude will be equals to zero, summation of this departure will be equals to zero. On simplifying, I will get L cos theta equals to, L cos theta equals to how much? 28.8. Okay. And here I will get L sin theta equals to minus 31. Okay. Here I will get L, say adding all things. Okay. Which is equals to zero. Summation of V equals to zero. Summation of H equals to zero. Okay. Add all things which is equals to zero. And departure add all things which is equals to zero. Okay. On solving this, we will get L cos theta equals to 28.8. And adding all these things, we will get L sin theta equals to minus 31. Okay. So now we want to determine the theta. That is.
Hello, sir. सर स्क्रीन दिसत नाही.
हां एक मिनिट. So adding all the latitudes, I will get, which is equating it equal to zero. Okay. By adding all the departures, I will get L sin theta equals to minus 31. So we have got this one. We'll keep it aside. Now theta we have to determine. So how you determine the theta? That is tan inverse D upon L. Okay. So what is the value of D here? It is that this is our L and this is our D. Substitute these things. 31 upon 28, we will get the angle. Okay. This is the reduced bearing. If I draw like this, north, south, east, west, it is making an angle of how much? 47 degree 6 minute 24 seconds. Okay, so later on you can convert it into whole circle bearing by 360 degree minus theta. Okay, we'll get in the whole circle bearing. Now the length of the DA, how will determine the length of the DA? That is summation of L square plus summation of D square. L square, D square, we have got this much. Okay, later on you can do for check. This is how we will do the calculation when he has given northing and southing. Okay, similarly here also we have, so here he has given the lines PQ, QR, RS, ST and TP. Okay, he has given the length of everything, but here he is telling to determine the missing thing. Okay, first one, listen very carefully. First line PQ, length is there, whole circle bearing there, will convert into reduced bearing. Now this latitude, how we will get? This is L cos theta, that is 194.1 multiplied by cos 85 degree 30 minutes. You will get this one. Okay, so here this is L sin theta, that is 194.1 multiplied by minus 85 degree 30 minutes. 194.1 multiplied by cos 85 degree 30 minutes. So it is it. Okay, it's correct. Then sine. Okay, this is also correct. Next, 201.20 multiplied by sine. So first we'll go for cos. Cos, how much it is? 15 degree 30 minutes. Okay, it is 138. Okay, did I get the same thing? Alpha A multiplied by alpha B. One second, 160. Because here he has not taken plus or minus, because this here there is some error. Okay. 164.40 multiplied by cos 285 degree 30 minutes 43. Okay. Next, we take this one as sine. See, this is negative. Okay, this is positive, this is negative. Another one, 201.20 multiplied by sine. Okay, this is also positive, 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 positive. Okay, here I will write the formula L cos theta, and here it is L sin theta. Okay, 172.6 multiplied by cos 195 degree 30 minutes. It is minus. Okay, here it is minus. And here it is also minus. Okay, so we have got plus, 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 minus, and here it is plus, plus, minus, minus. So what you do? And here he is asking the missing one. Okay, so we know that summation of L, okay, summation of L, which is equals to zero. Here it is summation of D equals to zero. What you do? Add all those things. Here also add all those things. Okay, here we don't have anything. So what we'll write? We'll write L cos theta. Here we will write L sin theta. Okay. So what we will do? This we will follow the same procedure as we done above. Okay, adding. So after doing the equating, we'll call this one as equation number one, equation number two. So you will go for calculating the theta. Okay, we'll determine the theta and with the help of this one we will determine the lengths. Okay, so the same procedure is followed here also. Okay, here we will find the theta and here we will find the l. Okay, once you get the l here, how much we have got l here? L, it is 615.96. Here 615.96. Okay, how much angle we have got? 47 degree 5 minute 47 seconds. Okay, then in whole circle bearing also it will be the same, north 47 degree 5 minutes 47 east. Okay, then how we'll write the latitude here? That is L multiplied by this one, L cos theta, you will get value here. L, how much it is? 615 multiplied by sin theta, you will get the things here. Okay, so take this one as assignment, take the screenshot. Okay, I hope you have taken the screenshot. I will go another one, question paper numerical. Okay, right now I'm not getting any previous year question paper. So I'm seeing that all are the similar one, similar questions are there. Here we, they are given the coordinates. Here also the same. So what you do, at least solve 5 numericals. Okay, 5 numericals on these types of problems. Okay, latitudes and longitude departures. Okay, and these are very simple, they may ask in the MCQs. Okay, try to solve. If you get any difficulties means, then you can ask me, or you can just take a screenshot and send me the numerical. Okay, which one you are getting not able to solve. So in next class I will solve those types of numericals. So and differentiates, we are at the last concept. Now if it is your offline paper, okay, then they will ask it, and it is very important. So what is telescope normal and telescope invert? Okay, initially I have shown you some figure also. Okay, if this is your telescope and here you have a scale, sorry, this is your telescope. Okay, this is your axis, and from here you are observing, and the scale it is towards the left hand side. Vertical scale it is towards the left hand side, we will call it as a normal position. Okay, when you tilt or when you rotate the telescope in 180 degree and your eyepiece come here, and this is your telescope, and vertical scale, if it is come towards your right hand side, then we will call it as an inverted position or left face or face left. So initially I have explained and I have showed you some figures also. So if the vertical circle of an instrument is on left side of the observer while taking the reading, it is called as the telescope normal. Okay, what is invert telescope? If it is towards the right side, okay, this one. Now observation taken with the telescope normal is left face, and observation taken with telescope normal is right face. Okay, next, what is swinging and tilting? Again the same thing, it is the procedure of turning the telescope about the horizontal axis in 180 degree in a vertical plane. Okay, then what is swinging? It means turning the telescope around the vertical axis in a horizontal plane. The second point, it is known as the plunging or reversing. Okay, transiting is nothing but the rotating the telescope in a 180 degree. Swinging, it is called as right swing. Okay, in repetition method. Okay, I've explained you. This is A, B. Here I will make zero. I will take the reading. I have got 30 degree. Then again I will rotate my telescope in a clockwise direction. Again here initial reading it will be 30 degree. Here it will be 60 degree. Again I rotate my telescope in a clockwise direction. Here it will be 60 degree. Here it will be 90 degree. So difference upon all of this is 30 degree. So this is called as a swinging of a telescope in a clockwise direction or in anti-clockwise direction. Okay, repetition method and reiteration method, we have already seen in the compass survey the same thing. This method is used for accurate work. Okay, in this method the same angle is measured for n number of times. Repetition method, just now I explained you this one. Same angle it is measured for n number of times, that is 3 times 4 times. Okay, after that we will take the mean of it or average of it, we'll call it as a repetition. In this work the method, the same angle is measured for n number of times and the value observed is by taking the average. Okay, suppose if you have taken the two readings, that is theta 1 plus theta 2 divided upon 2, average we will take. If you have done 3 times, that is theta 1 plus theta 2 plus theta 3 upon 3. Okay, we will take the average one in repetition method. What is reiteration method? In compass surveying what we have done, the same thing. This method consists in measuring the several angle successfully and finally closing the horizontal at the same point. Means from here we are starting. Okay, L, M, N, O, O is not there, P, and again in here, L. You are coming here, you are taking here, and you are taking here. Okay, this is what? The reiteration method. So anybody having any doubt in this unit? Anybody having doubt in this unit? Okay.
No, sir.
Right. No. And send me within 2 days. Okay. If possible, afternoon I will take another new unit. I'm planning to take for the third year. If not possible, I will take the class for you. Okay. So the one thing is that sit near the mobile up to 5 p.m. I can take the class at any time. Okay, due to busy schedule during previous month due to admission work and etc. So I was not able to take the classes. So now we are all the faculties are literally free now. So what you do, just be aware the what messages you are getting in the groups. Okay. So you can comment your roll numbers and you can leave the class.